In this video, I'm going to show you how to remove anything from a photo using several Photoshop techniques. The first thing that I'm going to do is press Ctrl-J, Command-J on the Mac, and that duplicates the layer. So you always want to have the ability to come back to the original layer just in case you make a mistake. So with the duplicate active, I'm going to select the lasso tool, which allows me to freehand a selection. So I'm quickly going to trace a selection around the soccer player. You don't have to be very precise, but try to get as much of the original pixels as possible. You can hold Alt Option on the Mac and click and drag to subtract from the selection, or you can hold Shift, click and drag to add to the selection. So I'm just going to quickly refine the selection once again to try to get as many of the original pixels as possible. And I'll go in between his arms. Once you have the selection active, you can hold Shift and Backspace to bring up the Fill dialog box. Make sure that you select Content Aware under Contents. In Photoshop CC, click on Color Adaptation. If you're in an older version of Photoshop, then you won't have that option. When you're done, press OK. And Photoshop will analyze the pixels surrounding the selection to generate the fill. It's not going to be a perfect fill, but that's okay. I'm going to press Ctrl-D, Command-D to deselect. What we're going to do now is select the Patch tool. Make sure that Normal is selected under Patch and that Source is selected. Then we can simply click and drag on these blurry areas and sample from a similar area in Release, and notice how Photoshop removed those blurry areas. So I can keep doing that all throughout the image. Just click and drag to sample, Ctrl-D, Command-D to deselect, and click and drag. And you can, of course, take your time fine-tuning the adjustments. Then I'm going to press the Z key on the keyboard, and I'm going to zoom in to this problem area. And one of the easiest ways of fixing this area is by selecting the Clone Stamp tool. Use the right bracket key on the keyboard to increase the size of the brush, and then hold Alt Option on the Mac and click to sample from an area like the sky here, and I can simply start painting away the areas that don't work on my image. Obviously, I'm going fairly quickly here, but take your time when you're working on your image. Also, here's a technique that you probably will enjoy. If I hold Alt Option on the Mac and click here on the corner, I can start painting in those pixels. However, if I increase the size of the brush, you will see that the scale is not accurate. You can actually change the scale and rotation of the brush by using a keyboard shortcut. If you hold Alt Shift and the greater than key or the less than key, you'll notice that I rotate the sample source. If I hold Alt Shift and the right bracket key, I can increase or decrease the scale of my sample source. See that? So I can use that smaller version to paint in those pixels. So let me reduce the size of the brush and paint in those pixels like so. And I'm just worried about the bleachers here. And then I can come in and paint the sky. And by the way, those keyboard shortcuts only work with the North American keyboards. So if you don't have a North American keyboard, then you can go into Window and select Clone Source, and you'll see the scale and rotation options here. What I'm gonna do is reset the transform. That way I can copy the fence here and finish off this effect. Also, if this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, then don't forget to click on that subscribe and notification buttons. Thank you so much for watching.